Let's welcome the new year with a revolutionary approach to 3D design. In this tutorial, I'll show you how to create 3D repeater using 3D models in After Effects. So I'll start by creating a new composition, and from the presets, I'll choose the social media square preset, and I'll change the duration to 5 seconds and click OK. Then I'll open up my source files folder and drag this freebie gradient texture, let's go with 02, that I got from indieground.net. The link is down below. I'm also going to open up my models folder and drag this energy drink that I got from sketchfab.com, and you can get the same model if you like to follow along using the link in the description. So first, I'll play with the Z rotation here, just so we can have a better look at the label. So I'll set it to start at -155, and I'm also going to create a keyframe for it. I'll scale the model down to 50, and I'm also going to place it in the lower left of the composition. So I'll change the Y value to 800, and this will make sense in a moment. For now, I'll go all the way to the end, and I'll animate the rotation Z to somewhere around -220. So this is what we have so far. Okay, I'll go to the beginning and then I'll create a new light. This, of course, is going to be an environment light. I'll switch off cast shadows and click OK. And then I'll open up the transform and I'll play with the X rotation to get a better lighting on this 3D object. So -120. And you know what? I'm going to also animate this. So I'll go to the end, I'll create a keyframe for the X rotation with this value, and then over here at the beginning, I'll set it back to 0. So it's going to start dark, and then across time, it will become brighter. All right, now I'll close the light and the model. And I want to repeat it many times, but as you may know, we can't apply effects directly to 3D models. So to create the main 3D repeater effect, I'm going to create a new solid by pressing Command Y, and I'm going to name it Instance, making sure it is set to the comp size, and I'll click OK. To this layer, I'll apply under Effect, Channel, the CC Composite effect. And I will reference the 3D model over here. So this means that I can now switch off the visibility of the 3D model because the CC Composite is going to render it for us. Now we do want to see the background, so I'll change the transfer mode to copy, and then I'll switch off RGB only. Then I'll select the layer in the timeline and press R to see the rotation. I'll hold down Option, Alt on Windows, and click on the stopwatch, which is going to allow me to write a simple expression. The expression is going to be index times 20. And this will take the index number of the layer and multiply it by 20, which will make sense in a moment when we'll duplicate this layer many times. However, I also want each copy to change its color. So I'll accept the expression, and then I'll reselect the layer, go to the Effect menu, and from the Color Correction category, I'll apply the Color Balance in parentheses HLS. I'll double-click on the hue to expose it in the timeline, and then I'll use the property Peak Whip and point it to the rotation. So basically, it's going to follow the same expression, meaning that if I need to change the expression, I only need to change it over here. Now I can close the effect as well as collapse the entire layer, and then I'll reselect it and press Command D, this will be Control D on the Windows side, to duplicate as many copies as I need in order to create a full circle. And now that we have the basic repeater form, we can add a camera and animate it to create a 3D dance of all those duplicated layers. So I'll go to the layer menu and under new, I'll create a new camera. I'll choose the 35mm preset and click OK. To get a more predictable animation, I'll right-click on the camera And from the camera options, I'll create an orbit null. So I can use this null object, which is placed in the center of the composition, to animate the camera. I'll open up its settings, and under transform, I'll create keyframes for the position, as well as the Y rotation, and maybe also the X rotation. I'll change the X rotation to begin with to negative 90 degrees, which is going to look like this. So all the battles are now one on top of the other. And then I'll go to the end of the timeline and set it back to zero. And then I'll also plug another value for the Y rotation. So let's go with negative 30, just so we'll have a different angle of those battles. And then I can play with the Z position of this null object, which is going to move the camera. So I'll start to drag it. Let's see how this looks over here. Maybe a touch more until I found something that I like. Let's just round it up to 200. All right, let's go to the beginning. Select all the values that has keyframes. We can also press U to just see those values. And then I'm just going to select the names of the properties. Press F9 to easy ease the motion, as well as pay a short visit to the graph editor. Go all the way to the end. Make sure to select the last value over here. And by the way, I'm editing the speed graph. And then I'll click on this handle, hold down shift and move it to the left. So it's going to slow down the animation towards the end. I'll go to the beginning and let's preview it by pressing spacebar. Looks nice, doesn't it? Now to get the background to move with the scene, we can select the layer. So let's scroll down the timeline. I'll select the layer and then I can apply from the perspective category, the CC environment effect, which is going to make the background react to the camera. Now, since this is not a seamless image, I'll choose the probe mapping, and then I'll play with the horizontal pan until I found something that I like. So maybe around 40. Let's check it towards the end. It looks good. And also let's check it at the beginning. And you know what? Let's just preview it again to see how this works with the 3D elements. Now you can play with the original 3D model to get a different variation or change the values of the camera or the orbit null. But I actually like what I got. So I'm going to go all the way towards the end, return to the project panel, and I'll drag another copy of this 3D battle on top of all the layers. And then I'll change its orientation to 35 for the X, 60 for the Y, and 345 for the Z. I'm also going to change the Z rotation to positive 90 degrees. And then I'll move its X position, so it will be in the middle of the scene. So 620, just to give you some round numbers. Now I'll create keyframes at the end for the position, as well as the scale, and also the Y rotation. And then I'll go to 1 second and 15 frames. This is where I want the battle to start appearing. And then I'll change the Y rotation revolutions. I'll plug in -1 and I'll scale it to 0. And I think that I also need to move it up and a bit to the left. So something like this, and I may need to fiddle with it. So I'll move it down just so it would look like it is coming from the middle of this array. And finally, I'll select all of these keyframes values, press F9 to easy ease the animation, go to the beginning, maximize the composition and preview it. Well, I think it looks cool and was quite easy to achieve. What do you think? Let me know in the comments below. As you form your feedback, have a look at another composition that I've created using the same principles. I'll maximize it and play it for you. This time, this is a sport shoe, or to be more exact, sport shoes in plural. In this composition, I've animated the scale of each instance as well as shift the start of each layer to create a cascade animation. I've also added a simple text and of course the Adidas logo. Now I must say that Adidas has nothing to do with this video. They didn't sponsor it and it's safe to assume that they never heard about my channel. But you did! So if you feel like it, please like and subscribe and maybe also share this video with your friends. In any case, thank you so much for watching and I will see you again in the next one.